Hi, my name's Rachel from PRW Training, and today I'm going to guide you through a fairly Pilates-based abdominal workout. We're going to go through some of the warm-up exercises, the ab prep, and a single leg extension, and then we'll just go through a few basic plank positions so you've got an idea of how to be able to progress as we go through. So I'm going to get you to lie down on your back. And I'm just going to use a cushion to just place between my knees so that I'm hip distance apart, and that'll just give me a little bit of feedback through the inside thighs and will help me fire up the pelvic floor a little bit better. We're lying down on the back, so you want to be nice and relaxed. The feet aren't too close towards the bum, they're not too far away. You want to make sure that the back is just feeling nicely supported. We're going to feel the tailbone nice and heavy into the floor. We feel the lower rib cage nice and heavy into the floor. The lower back is then just in a nice neutral alignment with no pressure being held on it. And I just want you to take a nice deep breath in. As you breathe out, find the pelvic floor and gently engage about 25%, drawing the pelvic floor up inside. Breathe in and relax everything. Now the neck and shoulders are nicely released. You breathe out. We connect through the pelvic floor, feel it drawing up, and then connect round the abdominal muscles to create almost a corset-like sensation around the waist. And then breathe in and release. So we're just trying to calm everything down. We're taking any pressure out of the neck and shoulders, and just keep on breathing like that. Feeling as you breathe out that you're really tightening through the waist and feeling that nice support around the transversus abdominis is giving you that nice support around the waist, and the pelvic floor is gently engaging. From here, we're going to inhale. We're going to bring the arms straight up to the ceiling. Now the spine doesn't change its shape and the rib cage remains nicely held here by the abdominal muscles. And we're going to lengthen the arms over the back of the head as you breathe out. We inhale, bring the arms back up to the ceiling. And then we exhale and we place the hands down, okay? Inhale, reach the arms up to the ceiling. As you exhale, lengthen the arms over the back of the head, focusing on those abdominal muscles. Your arms might not get down to the floor, not many people can. And then we bring the arms back up to the ceiling and then place them back down to your sides. Inhale, reach the arms up. Keep focusing on those abdominal muscles. Breathe out and lengthen the arms behind you. Inhale, bring the arms back up to the ceiling. Exhale, place them hand down. Now we're going to circle the arms. We inhale as we reach the arms up and over the back of the head. Circle the arms around and bring them back down by your sides. Inhale, reaching the arms up over the top of the head. Circle the arms around, bring it down to your side. One more this direction. Reaching the arms up over the back of the head. Circle around and then back down to your sides. Now reverse it. Open the arms out. Lead with the thumbs as you come over the top of the head, reaching it forward and down by your side. Inhale, and then exhale as you come over the top of the head. One more time. Inhale as we go round, and then exhale as we come back down by your sides. Good, okay. From here, we're gonna just do a little head nod so the body remains nice and stable. And you're just gonna inhale, and you're keeping the head in contact with the floor, and it's just a little nod of the head. And then as you exhale, the eyeline goes back up to the ceiling. Feel like someone's got a towel underneath your head and they're just gently pulling it away. So we inhale, the eyeline goes towards the knees, and then we exhale and we come back up to the ceiling. Inhale, lengthen the back of the neck, and then exhale, come back up to the ceiling. It's very small. Now that movement will put you into the correct alignment for the neck as we go into your curl up. So we inhale, draw the chin to the chest. Now we're going to curl up. We breathe out, we're going to connect the rib cage to the hips. Reach the arms forward, the shoulders are nicely relaxed. Inhale and hold. Exhale, you're going to roll back down through the spine, one vertebra at a time, and release the head at the end. Inhale, chin to chest. Exhale, curl up. Inhale, hold. Exhale, keep the eye line towards the knees as you roll back down, and then release the head at the end. Inhale, draw the chin to the chest. Exhale, curl up using that rib cage, shortening the distance here. Inhale and hold. Exhale, and then we lower back down. Keep those eyes forward and then release at the last moment. Two more times. Inhale, chin to chest. Exhale, curling up. Feel that corset around your waist. Inhale and hold.
Exhale, lowering it back down. Eyeline staying forward and then releasing. Last one. Inhale, chin to chest. Exhale, curling up. Hold it there. And then exhale, lower back down. Release everything. Now we're going to come into that curl up and we're going to pulse forward 4 times using the rib cage to do the pulse. So you're wanting to shorten the distance between your rib cage and your hips, and that's what's doing the pulse. So we inhale, chin to chest. Exhale, curl up, reaching towards the ankles. Now deepen that curl up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lower all the way back down. If the neck is taking over, take the hands behind the head. So we inhale, draw the chin to the chest, and then use the arms to support that neck, and then increase the curl up, increase the curl up. 3, 4, release all the way back down. We're doing that 3 more times. Inhale, chin to chest, exhale, curl up, and then we reach. 2, 3, 4, lower back down. Now you're not pulling onto the neck, you're allowing the head to push back into the hands and the hands to push into the head. Inhale, chin to chest. Exhale, curling up. And we reach. 2, 3, 4. And lower back down. Let's try it with the arms down by the side again. Inhale, chin to chest. Exhale, reaching forward. And then deepen the curl up. 2, 3, 4. Lower all the way back down. Good. Just allow the head to drop side to side. Make sure that it's not taking any pressure. I'm going to get rid of the cushion. So, from here, we're going to bring the legs to tabletop. So we bring one leg up to a 90 degree bent angle. The spine is now flat into the floor. We bring the other leg up. Now just feel that you're nicely supported here. If you feel that you just need to bring the knees into the chest, make sure that that back is nicely lengthened. That's absolutely fine. We're going to work just the legs. So the stomach muscles are going to keep that spine nicely held into the floor. Do not let it escape, okay? So we're not arching the back at all. We're making sure that the tummy is pulling that spine into the floor at all times. We're going to lengthen one leg away, and then you're going to switch those legs over 20 times. Neck and shoulders remaining nice and relaxed. Off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, keep pulling down here, 10, 11, 12, nice and long with the leg, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, good. Bring the knees into the chest, just hug them, allow the legs to just rock gently side to side, do a little bit of a circle with the legs if you need to, and then the other direction. Okay, so from here, we're going to do exactly the same things with the legs, switching them over 20 times, but your hands are going to go behind the head and we're going to do it in a curl up. So come into that tabletop position first, one leg up and then the other leg up. Just release that spine, make sure that the stomach muscles are holding it into the back. We inhale, we look towards the knees. We exhale, we curl up. Now the body and the head is not going to remove anywhere. We're keeping that nice and stable. We reach one leg away and then we switch them over 20 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nice and long in that leg. 9, 10, 11, 12. Keep pulling those stomach muscles down. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Bring the knees in, lower the head. Just hug the knees for a moment. Rock side to side. And a little gentle circle each direction. Good. Okay, this time you're going to do it with the Pilates arms. So if the neck starts taking over, just grab the head again. But if we can feel that we can keep that stability, we're going to challenge your coordination. So from here, your one leg goes extended, the inside hand comes to the knee, the outside hand goes to the ankle. You're in this curl up, and then we switch the arms and the legs on each repetition, okay? So we're in the tabletop position to start with. One leg at a time, find that flatness into the back. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, curl up. We lengthen one leg away. We bring the inside hand to the knee, the outside hand to the ankle. Keep that connection through the abdominals, and then we switch it over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Lengthen those toes. 8, 9, 10. Keep pulling the tummy muscles in. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, bring the knees in, rock it from side to side. You should start feeling a little bit of a warmth into the ribcage area here, circling those legs. We're going to bring the legs back down to the floor. Taking the hands behind the head. Again, I want that 5% pressure, head into the hands, hands into the head. And we're going to twist through the rib cage, and you're going to try and reach your shoulder to the opposite knee. So we inhale to prepare, and then as we exhale, we twist. We bring it back to the center. We breathe out, we twist the opposite direction. We bring it back to the center. Breathing out and rotate. And release. Use the rib cage here and reaching the shoulder. Don't let the elbow come in front of your head, and make sure that the neck isn't taking the pressure. So use the hands to be able to take the weight of the head, some of the weight of the head. We twist. Now the hips shouldn't be moving at all. And you should start feeling that nice rotation through the rib cage. We've got the last one here. And then breathe and relax. Lengthen the legs away, just take the arms over the top of the head, and that will give you a nice stretch through the middle. Okay, so now we're going to add the legs. So you're going to be in a curl up, and as you reach, you're trying to reach the shoulder towards the knee, and then we come back to the center. We twist and we come back to the center, okay? So the legs are in a nice tabletop position, spine is nicely held into the floor. Inhale to prepare. As you exhale, you curl up and we reach and we bring it to the center. Reach, bring it to the center. Reach, bring it to the center. Pull those stomach muscles up and underneath the rib cage. Lengthen through that leg. Squeeze, don't let the elbow come across the face. We've got three more. Reach, back in. Two, back in. Last one, lengthen through. In, one foot down, other foot down, lengthen through the legs, arms over the top of the head, stretch through the body. Okay, we're now going to do that double paced, okay? So we're just going to not have that pause in between, and we're just going to lengthen and twist and twist and twist. So, one leg up to tabletop, other leg up to tabletop, hands behind the head, and we curl up. We're then going to lengthen, off we go. Twist, two, three, four, five. Pull those stomach muscles down, up and underneath the rib cage. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And bring the knees in, gently rock side to side, circle it around and circle it around. Okay, so that's your single leg extension. Or single leg stretch, nice and long through the body here. So now we're just going to give you a couple of planks to be able to just make sure you know what you're doing there. So the first position I'm going to get you to do it in is on the forearms, but we're going to do it on the knees. So from here, you're just going to find a nice stable position and you're just going to stay here. So what I want you to be aware of is that you're keeping the glutes nicely engaged. You're keeping the connection through the ribcage to the hips. Nice and long through the spine. And we're not taking any tension in the hands. Personally, I like my hands facing towards each other. That keeps me in a nice alignment. Some people have their palms down. Some people interlink the hands. I tend to have my hands here. So it's whatever feels comfortable for you. You're feeling the shoulder blades keeping connected at the back. And we're just holding it. And it should feel quite nice and working into those abdominal muscles. We're going to hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then release. Good, okay, one more. So from here, we're going to do it onto the hands. So we're going to bring the hands directly underneath the shoulders, and we're going to have the toes gently tucked underneath. You're going to feel that pressure down into the floor. I would bring the feet together, and then you can squeeze those inside thighs together. Feel that elongation through the body, and we're holding it here. Good, keep the connection, rib cage to hips. Keep squeezing those glutes, pushing those hands down into the floor. Nice long line, head to heel. Let's go for 5,
four, three, two, one. Come back down onto the knees. Well done.